الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأولين والآخرين وأشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، المعروف في أعلى السماوات بأحمد، وعلى وجه الأرضين بأبي القاسم محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد،
وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين، المعصومين المنتجبين، الغر الميامين، ولا سيما حجة الله في الأرضين وقائم الهداة المهديين، الحجة المهدي المنتظر، عجل الله تعالى فرجه الشريف، وأرواحنا وأرواح العالمين له الفداء. قالت سيدتنا ومولاتنا عقيلة بني هاشم زينب الكبرى عليها السلام في قصر يزيد بالشام: فوالله لا تمحو ذكرنا ولا تميت وحينا. Our Lady Zainab al-Kubra, daughter of Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam, said in the palace of Yazid in Sham, by Allah, you shall never be able to remove our mentioning nor to kill our revelation. Ta'jeelan li faraj Mawlana sahib al-Zaman, to hasten the holy appearance of sahib al-Zaman alayhi salam, and to be among his supporters and companions. Please recite one loud salawat ala Muhammadin wa Ali Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
Before 1,375 years, 1,375 years, Sayyidah Zainab al-Kubra alayhi salam gave this promise to Yazid and all the tyrants of the world. فوالله لن تمحو ذكرنا ولن تميت وحينا. By Allah, you shall never be able to remove our mentioning nor to kill our revelation. And today, in 2015, after 1,375 years, you can see the same words of Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam are manifested in Iraq in the days of Arba'een. And you can see this mentioning and this love increasing for Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam day after day. And you can see that all the world's media and TVs are following and covering what they call it the world's biggest pilgrimage. And they call it the world's biggest human procession. With more than 25 million of people. And you can see all these millions and millions of people, men and women, old and young, and even children, all walking towards one destination. And when you ask each and every one of them, what brought you here? What made you go through all this pain and walk all this distance? They will tell you, Al-Husayn. They asked a young girl, only 5 years old girl, you walked all the way from Basra to Karbala. Do you know where is Basra? Any Iraqis here in the majlis? Brothers from Iraq? Anyone knows where is Basra?
500.
MashaAllah, South Iraq. 500 kilometers away from Karbala. You walked all this way from Basra to Karbala. Didn't your feet hurt you? This little girl looked at them, smiled, and said, Fidwa lil-Hisyan. You are Iraqis, you know what is Fidwa lil-Hisyan. And I want to sacrifice for Hussein. And now you go today and you see the same words of Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam are manifested in the way of Mashaya, the walking visitors between Najaf and Karbala. Manifested in all these millions of lovers who by their walking and their ziyara, they are saying the same words of Zainab al-Kubra. فَوَاللَّهِ لَن تَمْحُوا ذِكْرَنَا وَلَن تُمِيتْ وَحْيَنَا
صَلُّوا عَلَى مُحَمَّدْ وَآلِ مُحَمَّدْ
اللَّهُمَّ صَلِّ عَلَى مُحَمَّدْ وَآلِ مُحَمَّدْ.
And these days, from the shahada of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, in the 10th of Muharram, till the 20th of Safar, Al-Arba'een, these 40 days were the most painful 40 days for Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. It was a journey of suffering from Karbala to Damascus and then back to Karbala. A journey of suffering, pains, torturing, humiliation, and captivity. The most painful days for Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. But nowadays, if you come to our Shias and you ask them, you ask the Shias of Ahlul Bayt, what do you know about these 40 days? They will tell you that they took Ahlul Bayt from Karbala to Sham. But then what happened in between? What are the calamities and the masa'ib they faced in their way of captivity? Who are the members of Ahlul Bayt who passed away in this way due to torturing and whipping? Who are they? And why you can find some of the shrines very far in Baalbek, northeast of Lebanon, and in Aleppo, near the borders with Turkey? Why there? And what are the places they went through? And when did they arrive to Damascus? When you ask all these questions, you will be amazed to see the Shias of Ahlul Bayt, Shias of Amir al-Mu'mineen, they will hesitate before answering. And they will not have much to say. You may know many lives of our Imams alayhi salam, but we always have this uncertainty and some scattered ideas here and there. And the main reason for this uncertainty, that these ideas and this history of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam was not presented to us in a simple and clear way. And inshallah, what we are doing tonight will present a very important period of history of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, which is this 40 days, in a very simple, clear and brief way. Inshallah, we will explain all the journey, all these 40 days at the beginning, only in 3 minutes, very clear and very brief, and then inshallah we'll go into details of this journey of suffering of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. Inshallah we'll discuss all that, starting by one loud salawat ala Muhammadin wa Ali Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad.
إن شاء الله ضمن المحاضرة رح مرق شوية عربي يعني للإخوة اللي يرتاحوا أكثر بالعربي بس هلا رح نبلش بالإنجليزي معه. So this journey of suffering of Ahlul Bayt عليهم السلام revolves around two main cities. We have Karbala in the south of Iraq and Damascus in the south of Syria. They went from Karbala to Damascus and then returned to Karbala. And all this journey took 40 days. And these soldiers of Yazid, they were able to take Ahlul Bayt in a very short cutway from the south of Iraq to the south of Syria. Very easy. In 10 days only. But they took the most distant way according to the orders of Yazid. He asked them to take them in the most distant way to suffer more and to torture Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam more. So instead of reaching in 10 days, they arrived in 20 days. So when is that if we count 20 days after the 10th of Muharram? I know that you are good in math, inshallah. Yes, brothers. End of Muharram, first of Safar. The day which was first of Safar, Wahad Safar, They entered to Damascus. دخلوا إلى الشام. So it took 20 days to explain it very clearly. I made this new way of this rectangle. You can see this rectangle, which will symbolize all the journey of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. First, we have in as like any other rectangle. How many angles we have here? MashaAllah, four angles. Very good. Four angles. We have these two main cities, which is Karbala here in the south of Iraq, here, and Damascus here in the south of Syria. So instead of taking them from this shortcut way, which will take 10 days only, they went first from Karbala here to here to the north of Iraq. There's a city here in the north of Iraq, and the Iraqis knows it, Al-Mosul. They went first here to Al-Mosul in the north of Iraq, and this way here up to the north. Then they came in this way towards Syria here. To make it more clear, I will turn this to this side. Now you can see here is Iraq, here is Syria, here this point is Karbala. They went up here to Mosul, here is Mosul, and then they came all this way to the north of Syria here. In north of Syria here we have Aleppo, Halab. And then from Aleppo in the north, they came here towards Damascus here in the south. And that's why we have Sayyida Khawla bintul Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam in Ba'albak. That's why we have in Ba'albak the shrine of the head of Imam Husayn, Maqam Ra's al-Imam Husayn, here in the middle of the way between Halab, Aleppo and Damascus. And then they arrived to Damascus in which day? What was the date when they arrived to Damascus? Ahsan, may Allah reward you. First of Safar. They arrived here, they remained for 1 week here. Then in the 8th of Safar, they were released. So Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam took the heads of Shuhada'i Karbala, took the women, took the children, and went back towards Karbala. Did he use all this long way? Why to suffer? He didn't take this long way. He took this shortcut way from here, from Damascus, in the south of Syria, to Karbala here, in the south of Iraq, and they arrived here in the day of, you should all know this, the day of Arba'in, Ahsan, 20th of Safar. They arrived here in the day of Arba'in, and by this line, the shape of this rectangle was completed. This is all the journey of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, which revolves around this main four cities in 40 days, and then they arrived to Karbala here on the 40th, which was the day of Arba'in. Inshallah, all this is clear. Inshallah, that you have got this knowledge. Please recite one salawat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
هي إن شاء الله كانت واضحة بالإنجليزي، بس أنا رح أرجع عيدة بالعربي. كل رحلة أهل البيت عليهم السلام، هيدي الأربعين يوم من عاشوراء إلى الأربعين مختصرة في هيدي الخريطة على شكل هيدا المستطيل. في عنا أربع زوايا بهيدا المستطيل. وهون عنا كربلاء في جنوب العراق، وعنا هون دمشق في جنوب سوريا. بدل ما ياخذوا اهل البيت عليهم السلام من هيدا الطريق المختصر بعشرة ايام، يزيد كان بده يعذب اهل البيت عليهم السلام اكثر، اخذهم من اطول طريق، جابوا اول شيء من كربلاء هون لفوق على الموصل، شمال سوريا، شمال العراق، على هيدي المدينه الموصل، بعدين اجوا هيك لهون على شمال سوريا على حلب، وبعدين من حلب نزلوا لتحت هيك باتجاه بعلبك، عشان هيك عندنا مقام راس الامام الحسين عليه السلام ببعلبك، وعن السيدة خولة عليه السلام ببعلبك، وبعدين اجوا على دمشق، وصلوا هون بواحد صفر، وبعدين بثمانية صفر بعد اسبوع الامام زين العابدين رجع، بس ما استخدم كل هيدا الطريق الطويل، استخدم هيدا الطريق القصير المختصر من هون من جنوب سوريا من دمشق الى كربلاء، ورجعوا يوم الاربعين وتم هيدا الشكل تبع المستطيل، وتمت كل هيدا الرحلة باربعين يوم. إن شاء الله واضح بالعربي كمان. صلى على محمد وآل محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
الآن سنذهب إلى تفصيل القصة إن شاء الله، سأختصرها لكم قدر الإمكان. Now, inshallah, we'll go into details in this story of suffering and pains and captivity of Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam. As you know, on the 10th of Muharram, they killed all Ahlul Bayt. Then they invaded the tents of Ahlul Bayt. They burnt the tents of Ahlul Bayt. They captivated the small children of Imam Hussein alayhi salam and tied them with ropes and chains. And then on the following night, which was the 11th night of Muharram, what we call it in Arabic, Laylat al-Wahsh, or what we call it in the Pakistani Indian culture, Shame Ghariban. Laylat al-Wahsh was the most painful night for Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. When Sayyidina Zainab al-Kubra alayhi salam remained alone with no Hussein, no Abbas, no Akbar, none of the young men and the men protecting them, and those burnt tents with the children and orphans of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. The most painful night for Ahlul Bayt with no protector. And the next day of that day, which will be which date? You are still with me, brothers? The next day will be 11th of Muharram. They took Ahlul Bayt away from Karbala. And to torture the hearts of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam more, they didn't take him from any other way. They took them from the middle of the battlefield. Why? To see the bodies of their beloved ones, their dear ones, without heads, severed on the sand of Karbala, to burn their hearts more. And in that day, the 11th, and in the next night, they were in their way to the next stop. What was their next stop after Karbala? Ahsan. Who said it? May Allah reward you, Hajj. Kufa. And these days, Kufa is connected to Najaf. Connected to Najaf. And you know that all your relatives and your friends who went for Ziyarah for Arba'in are walking from Najaf to Karbala. So they walk the same distance, but from Karbala to Kufa. Do you know how long is this distance? This distance? How long? No, brother. Ahsan. 80 kilometers. 80 kilometers they came from Karbala to Kufa. And they arrived to Kufa on the next day. What was the next day? You're still with me? Yes, brother? Ahsan, Ahsan. 12th of Muharram, they arrived to Kufa, the city of Kufa, which was the same capital of Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam, in which Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam was the Khalifa and the Amir. The same Kufa in which Zainab al-Kubra alayhi salam was the first lady and the teacher of the ladies of Kufa. But the same Zainab is entering today to Kufa with ropes and chains into her hands, into her neck, into her feet. They wanted to humiliate Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam as much as possible. So they took them through the most crowded street, the market of Kufa, Bazar Kufa. And to humiliate Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam more, they put them in the market where they used to sell the sheep and the cows on the dust to humiliate them more. Then Ibn Ziyad asked all people who want to look at the sabaya and the women, come and have a look. So one of his friends told him, oh, Ibn Ziyad, do you want all the Arab tribes to revolt and raise up against you? Because among the ladies, the captives, there are the wives of the companions of Imam Hussein, and they are from different Arab tribes, and these tribes will feel the shame and they will raise up against you. So Ibn Ziyad said, every tribe come and take your women. So Bani Tamim came and said, Ya Tamimiyya, ta'ali ilayna. A woman from Tamim, come to us. They took that lady. Bani Asad came and they took their woman. Bani Amir came and said, Ya Amiriyya, ta'ali ilayna. They took their woman. Other tribes came and took their women, and only one mu'mina woman remained with Ahlul Bayt, the ladies of Ahlul Bayt, from Bani Fazar. Her tribe came and said, Ya Fazariya, ta'ali ilayna. But this mu'mina lady, She did not want to leave Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. She wanted to suffer with them, to endure with them, and be with them in this musibah. But at the end, her tribe threatened her, Ya Fazariya, if you don't come, we will kill you, just to get rid of the shame. So Sayyida Zainab alayhi salam told her, Jazakillah khayran ya ukhta. May Allah reward you, sister, but go with your tribe. Because only they want the family of Muhammad to be humiliated. Then at that moment, Sayyida Zainab al-Kubra alayhi salam stood in the market of Kufa and gave her immortal, famous sermon, Khutbat al-Kufa, and said, وَيْلٌ لَكُمْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكُوفَةِ يَا أَهْلَ الْمَكْرِ وَالْخَدِيعَةِ وَالْخِدَاعِ أَتَدْرُونَ أَيَّ دَمٍ لِرَسُولِ اللَّهِ سَفَكْتُمْ وَأَيَّ كَرِيمَةٍ لَهُ أَبْرَزْتُمْ وَأَيَّ كَبِدٍ لَهُ فَرَيْتُمْ لَقَدْ جِئْتُمْ شَيْئًا إِبْدَى تَكَادُ السَّمَاوَاتِ يَتَفَطَّرْنَ مِنْهُ وَتَنْشَقُّ الْأَرْضُ وَتَخِرُّ الْجِبَالُ هَدًّا. Do you know that you've shed the very blood of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam? Do you know that you have captivated the daughter of Rasulullah? You've committed a big sin, big crime that will make the mountains to collapse. Then Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam gave his famous immortal khutbah, khutbah al-Kufa, and he told the people of Kufa how they killed his father, Imam Hussein, in Karbala, and how they killed all the children and all his cousins and his brothers, even the little infant Abdullah al-Radi' with an arrow in his neck. So the people of Kufa started to cry. To humiliate Ahlul Bayt more, they took them to the palace of Ibn Ziyad. And then they took them to the prison of Kufa. At that day, on the same day, a letter came from the king in Damascus. Who was the king in Damascus? Yazid la'natullahi alayh. He told Ibn Ziyad, now you have to send to me all the heads of the shuhada and all the women and the children. So Ibn Ziyad told his soldiers to take them to Damascus. But as I told you, they didn't take them in the shortcut way. We will return to this map. They didn't take them from here to here in this shortcut way, but they took them here, towards the north of Iraq, towards Mosul, passing through all these cities like Tikrit and the other cities, and in every city and every town, before arriving there, they were telling that city and town that the Khawarij, Al-Kuffar, who rose against Yazid, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Khalifa al-Muslimin, they were killed and captivated, and that's why it's a celebration day. It's Eid day. You have to wear your best clothes. You have to bring your children with their best clothes. And you should wait at the gate of that city to celebrate this victory. So whenever they were getting near to any city, these soldiers of Yazid were bringing the children of Imam Hussein alayhi salam down from the camels and make them walk chained towards the door of the city, where they will receive them with stones. When they pass by them, they will curse them and stone them, humiliate them and make fun of them. And in all these cities and towns, it was like this. Until they arrived to the north of Iraq, to Mosul. And in Mosul, it was no better than those other cities. And there they mistreated the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam and put it on a rock on the ground. But what happened after they left Mosul, these drops of blood which remained on that rock, they started to become fresh in every day of Ashura, in every year. And these people of Mosul, who were not from the fellows of Ahl Bayt, they started to gather around that rock and see this miracle, and started crying for Imam Hussein alayhi salam, and taking their hajat from this miracle of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, and they started to move towards the way of Ahlul Bayt and become the followers of Ahlul Bayt. And this went on till the days of Abd al-Malik bin Marwan, who was another Umayyad vicious king. He started to know that in Mosul there is a rock and there's the blood of Hussein there, and this blood is becoming fresh every year. And the people of Mosul who were loyal to us, they started to become followers of Ahlul Bayt. He got very worried and very afraid. See how powerful is a few drops of blood of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. It can shake a kingdom. It can shake that king and made him afraid. So this Abdul Malik bin Marwan sent a letter to his governor on Mosul and told him what to do. This governor came with some men with big hammers, and they broke that rock and they smashed it. But what happened after that? More people started to know the reality. More people started to know the truth. And this is the miracle of Imam Hussein. And more people started to join the way of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. And the Shias in Mosul increased. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Tawbah, verse 32, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, يريدون أن يطفئوا نور الله بأفواههم ويأبى الله إلا أن يتم نوره ولو كره الكافرون. They want to extinguish the light of Allah by their mouths, but Allah refuses except to perfect His light. This is the nur of Muhammad and Ali Muhammad salawatullah wa salamu alayhi.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
وصلنا هون لا شمال العراق لا الموصل. الآن هن بدهم يتجهوا باتجاه سوريا بهذا الخط من شمال العراق من الموصل إلى اتجاه سوريا. هون حد الموصل في بلدة اسمها سنجار. Here next to Mosul, they started coming towards Syria. Next to Mosul, there is a city or a place called Sinjar. And there in Sinjar, a little girl of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, due to the torturing and the severe whipping, this little girl passed away. Her name was Zainab. So Imam Zainal Abidin alayhi salam buried her there on a top of a hill in Sinjar. And today, if you go to Sinjar, you will see two hills facing each other. One is totally barren and the other one is full of greenery and roses and trees. And on the top of this hill, there's a beautiful shrine for Zainab bint Hussein alayhi salam. And because Mosul is in top Iraq, north Iraq, it is very far from Karbala to walk all the way in Arba'in like the people of Najaf do. Now the Shias of Mosul these days, they walk, instead of Karbala because it's very far, they walk towards Sinjar, towards Zainab bint Hussein alayhi salam, where you can see thousands of and thousands of Mu'mineen and Shia walking towards that little girl of Imam Hussein, Zainab bint Hussein, started to take their hajat from there. In that area, and the Iraqis know there are Christians in Tal Afar and these areas, so they started to come as well and take their hajat from there. Even the minority of Yazidis, they started to come and take their hajat from there. Imagine, dear brothers, a little girl of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, in a deserted area, no one knew Sinjar, has become the destination of thousands and thousands of mu'mineen and others from other religions as well. See, Yazid, what he wanted. He wanted from this long way to torture Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam more, to make them suffer more. But the planning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was different. The planning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was to leave in every area, in every spot, a shrine for Ahlul Bayt, a reminder for Ahlul Bayt, to remind people of their suffering and the revolution of Imam Hussein alayhi salam and the sacrifices of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. That's why you see there Zainab bint Hussein. You come to Baalbek, you see another daughter. Who is there in Baalbek? Ahsant Hajj, Khawla bint Hussein alayhi salam. You come to Damascus, you see another daughter of Imam Hussein. Who is in Damascus? Ahsant Hajj, Ruqayya bint Hussein alayhi salam. They left in every place a reminder and shrine of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. This is the planning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So from Sinjar, they went here towards Syria through all these cities, Nusaybin, Harran, until they arrived here to Aleppo. When these soldiers of Yazid arrived here to Aleppo, the beginning of Aleppo, they saw a very big and old church. And this church is called Martha Marotha Church. Martha Marotha. And Martha Marotha is one of the oldest churches in Syria and in the whole world. So they saw the church, and there is a big yard in front of the church. They were very tired. They decided to sleep that night there and rest in that yard. So they brought the children and the women, whipping them and hitting them, and took them on the corner of that yard and put them on the dust. And then they put the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam on the dust, on the ground. And then they started to sit and play chess next to the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. The priest of that church heard this noise of the soldiers and their laughing. So this priest came out of the church. He was amazed to see a group of children and ladies with pure faces, faces of light, sitting on the ground, chained with chains and ropes. He was amazed to see a head on the ground, full of light. And he was amazed to see these soldiers who were laughing and playing chess. He came to them and said, "Who are you? And who is this head for?" They said, "We are the soldiers of Khalifa al-Muslimin, Yazid bin Muawiyah." "And who is this head for?" "This is the head of Husayn bin Ali." He said, "Husayn, son of Fatima, daughter of your prophet?" They said, "Yes." He said, "If Isa al-Masih, Jesus the Christ, had a son, we'll protect him and put him in our eyes. And you cut off the head of your prophet's son and put it on the ground?" He went into that church, and then he came back with a bag of golden coins. He told these soldiers, "You are staying here till the morning. So I'll give you all this gold. Just keep this head with me till the morning. And in the morning, I'll return it for you." These soldiers looked at each other. They said, "We are going to get the gold, and the head again. We'll not lose anything." So they accepted happily. So they gave the head to this priest. This priest took the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, carried it, and went inside the church. He washed it and cleaned it from all the blood and the dust it had. He put it on a perfumed silk material. And he started to talk to the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. "O head, talk to me by the haqq of this noor I see in you. By the haqq of this shining light in your face." Then the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam told the priest, "O priest, ishhad an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah. وَسَأَكُونُ شَفِيعَكَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ I will intercede for you in the day of judgment." When this priest saw the head of Imam Hussein talking, he could not tolerate. He burst into crying. He hugged the head of Imam Hussein عليه السلام, started to cry loudly and say, وَيْلٌ لِقَوْمٍ قَتَلُوكَ وَيْلٌ لِقَوْمٍ ظَلَمُوكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَأَنَّ جَدَّكَ مُحَمَّدْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Then he started the whole night weeping and crying next to the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And because this priest was a skillful Roman sculptor, he wanted to make a sculpture, a statue for the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam to immortalize this painful scene. So the whole night, this priest, he sat next to this head and he was weeping and making this sculpture until the morning when he finished. When he finished in the morning, he could not tolerate anymore this suppression and oppression against Imam Hussein alayhi salam. He took out a sword and he attacked the soldiers of Yazid and he fought them, and then he was killed and he became a shaheed and he joined the martyrs with Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And now today, if you go to Aleppo, إذا بتروح اليوم على حلب بتشوفوا مشهد جميل، مقام جميل اسمه مشهد النقطة.
اسم غريب،
مشهد النقطة. You will see there in Aleppo a beautiful shrine, the shrine of a drop. Strange name, the shrine of the drop, to symbolize those drops of blood of Imam Hussein alayhi salam on that rock. And dear brothers, نعم. هلا رح أحكي لك شو صار. رح أحكي لك كل القصة التفاصيل ورح أحكي لك داعش شو عمله. There in that shrine, dear brothers and sisters who are listening, it's the only place in the whole world where you can still see the blood of Imam Hussein. You can see the blood of Imam Hussein on that rock. And it happened in different times, various times in history, that this blood has become fresh again, fresh again. And the last time was in 1995. In the day of Ashura, when a group of Zawars, Zaireen from Pakistan, they were doing Ma'tam, Latmiya, at that rock, around that rock, when this blood became fresh again. And Alhamdulillah, these brothers videotaped this miracle and spread it for all the lovers of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. And today, you go on YouTube and you search it, and you will see this miracle of the head of Imam Hussein of that rock and the blood coming out from that rock. And what happened to that sculpture, the sculpture that Christian made, Christian man? It was moved to another church, and now it is in Italy. Now today you go to Italy, to the Museum of Rome, you will see that they have specified a special room for that sculpture of the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And in 2001, a group of mu'mineen from Kuwait went there and took permission, and they took a photo of this, and they took this photo and put it in one of their Husseinis. And as well, you can go on internet and Google it and search it, and you will find this photo of the sculpture of the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And because this shrine is very important for us, the fellows of Ahlul Bayt, these takfiris, like the brother is asking, these takfiris tried several times to occupy this shrine in Aleppo. And they hit it with the mortar shells. I was not going to talk about these details, but because the brother asked us. كمل بالإنجليزي ولا أحكي بالعربي؟ نعم. And they hit the shrine with the mortar shells, and part of this shrine was destroyed by the mortar shells. But Alhamdulillah, until now, they could not get near to the shrine, and until now, Alhamdulillah, it's under control. Alhamdulillah, بفضل الصلاة على محمد وآل محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
نحن هون هلا بحلب، هون شمال سوريا، هون وصلنا، جينا من هون من موصل، وصلنا على حلب، بعد حلب صاروا ينزلوا باتجاه دمشق. هون النقطة الأخيرة تبع الوصول تبعك. بالطريق from Aleppo they went down to Damascus. Here we have Hama, a city in Syria called Hama. If you go today to Hama, you will see a shrine on top of a mountain, and this mountain is called Jabal Zain al-Abidin, because Imam Zain al-Abidin prayed there, so they made a shrine there. And then in Hams, they passed through Hams, and then at that time they passed through the Lebanese borders. And at that time, there was nothing called like Syria, Lebanon. All Syria, Lebanon, Palestine, and Jordan, all of it was called Ahsan, Bilad al-Sham, Sham. So they passed through these Lebanese areas, first to Hermel, then to Labwa, then they arrived to Aleppo, where Sayyida Zainab alayhi salam gave another lecture. And she told the people of Baalbek how they mistreated the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, how they killed them in Karbala. And there again, they mistreated the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam and put it on the ground. But again, you see that that place now has become the shrine of the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam in Baalbek. Maqam Ras al-Imam Hussein alayhi salam fi Baalbek. You will go to Baalbek, you'll see that beautiful shrine of the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And there again, another daughter passed away. Sayyida Khawla bint Imam Hussein alayhi salam. You will see again that this beautiful shrine with this golden dome of Sayyida Khawla bint Hussein alayhi salam. And you will see in these days of Arba'een, thousands and thousands of people, of mu'mineen, will march and walk on their feet from the capital city of Lebanon, from Beirut till Baalbek, to commemorate the Arba'een of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, and visit the shrine of Sayyida Khawla bint Imam Hussein, and visit the shrine of the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. See the planning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yazid wanted Al-Bayt to suffer more, but the planning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was to leave in every place, in every city, a reminder for Ahlul-Bayt alayhi salam. So after Baalbek, they arrived here to Damascus. And as you know, Damascus here was the capital city of Bani Umayyad. It was the capital city of their kingdom. So all the Umayyads declared that it's a national holiday. It's a national Eid. All people should celebrate Eid, because the Kafirs, the Khawarij, who rose up against Yazid, they were killed and captivated, and they will enter today to Damascus. What was that day when they entered to Damascus? Brothers?
First of Safar.
Ahsan. MashaAllah, may Allah reward you. First of Safar. All of the people of Damascus, they were waiting by Bab al-Sa'at. So Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam entered from Bab al-Sa'at, and they went into the souq of Damascus, with which they call it today souq al-Hamidiyah. And there, because they thought that these are the Khawarij, they started again stoning Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, and cursing them, and humiliating them. And they even poured boiling water from the top of the roofs on the heads of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. And then they were taken to the palace of Yazid. And there in the palace of Yazid, Yazid was sitting with his ministers and members of his government, putting the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam in front of him, and hitting the lips of Imam Hussein alayhi salam with his stick, and saying those lines of poetry, those lines of kufr and ilhad, where he says openly that he is kafir. What he says? He says, لَعِبَتْ هَاشِمُ بِالْمُلْكِ فَلَا خَبَرٌ جَاءَ وَلَا وَحْيُ النَّزَلِ. He's saying openly, وَلَا وَحْيُ النَّزَلِ. He is admitting openly his kufr and ilhad and atheism. So Sayyida Zainab alayhi salam stood and gave her famous lecture there. And she said, يَا يَزِيد فَكِدْ كَيْدَكْ وَسْعَ سَعْيَكْ وَنَاصِبْ جُهْدَكْ فَوَاللَّهِ لَا تَمْحُو ولا تميت وحينا. By Allah, you shall never be able to remove our mentioning, nor to kill our revelation. Then Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam stood, and he gave his famous sermon, and he told the people of Sham the reality that they are the very family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. He told them who is his great grandfather. He said, أنا ابن مكة ومنى أنا ابن زمزم والصفا أنا ابن خير من حج ولبى أنا ابن خير من طاف وسعى أنا ابن من حمل على البراق في الهوى أنا ابن من أسري به من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى أنا ابن من بلغ به جبرائيل سدرة المنتهى أنا ابن من دنا فتدلى فكان قاب قوسين أو أدنى دنوا واقترابا من العلي الأعلى أنا ابن من صلى عليه ملائكة السماء مثنى مثنى أنا ابن من أوحى إليه الجليل ما أوحى أنا ابن محمد المصطفى.
اللهم صل على محمد.
Then he told them, who is his grandfather? He said, أنا ابن من ضرب بين يدي رسول الله بسيفين وطعن برمحين وهاجر الهجرتين وبايع البيعتين وقاتل ببدر وحنين ولم يكفر بالله لم يكفر بالله طرفة عين ليث الحجاز وكبش العراق وارث المشعرين وأبو الصبطين الحسن والحسين ذاك جدي علي بن أبي طالب. Then he told them, who is his grandmother? He said, أنا ابن سيدة النساء. أنا ابن فاطمة الزهراء. أنا ابن الطهر البتول. أنا ابن بضعة الرسول. Then he told them, who is his father? And look at these words of Imam Zain al-Abidin. As if he is reciting Majlis of Aza for us. Imam Zain al-Abidin says, أنا ابن المقتول ظلما. أنا ابن محزوز الرأس من القفا. أنا ابن العطشان حتى مضى. أنا ابن مسلوب العمامة والردى. أنا ابن من رأسه على السنان يهدى. أنا ابن من حرمه من العراق إلى الشام تسبى. I am the son of the one whose head is on a spear, presented as a gift. I am the son of the one whose women and ladies are captivated as slaves from Iraq to Sham. At that point, the people of Sham started to cry loudly as they started to know that this is the very family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So Yazid became very afraid and very worried from any uprising from the people of Sham. So he told Imam Zain al-Abidin that you are released and you are free to go wherever you want. So Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam, on the 8th of Safar, he gathered all the ladies, he took the heads of Shuhada'i Karbala, and he took all the children and wanted to go back to Karbala. He took with him all the children except one child, Sayyidah Ruqayya alayhi salam, who passed away inside the prison of Sham. So we are here, in this point, in this last point here in Damascus, and Imam alayhi salam left here Damascus on the 8th of Safar, and went in this shortcut way. He didn't take all this long way. Why to suffer more? ليش حتى يعذب حاله الإمام؟ ليش حتى يرجع من كل هيدا الطريق الطويل اللي هن عذبون فيه؟ لا، الإمام عليه السلام استخدم هيدا الطريق القصير المختصر من دمشق هون في جنوب سوريا إلى كربلاء هون في جنوب العراق. And he left here on the 8th of Safar and arrived here on which day? أحسنت، 20 صفر 20th of Safar, the day of 40. And before Imam Zain al-Abidin there in Karbala, Jabir bin Abdullah al-Ansari arrived with Atiyya al-Awfi. Jabir came to the grave of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Until he reached to the grave, he fell on the grave and started calling 3 times, Ya Hussein, Ya Hussein, Ya Hussein, until he fainted on the grave. Then he woke up. He and Atiyya saw some people coming from the side of Sham. He said, oh Atiyya, go and see if they are the soldiers of Yazid so we can hide somewhere. And if it's my master Zain al-Abidin, tell me to receive him. So Atiyya went and then he came back and he said, oh Jabir, it's your master, your Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam, coming with the women of Ahlul Bayt and the heads of Shuhada and the children of Hussein. So Jabir came and received the Imam. They hugged each other. They started to cry loudly. Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam said, هنا يا جابر قتلت رجالنا هي او جابر او من وكلد هنا يا جابر ذبحت اطفالنا هي او جابر او children were slaughtered هنا يا جابر سبيت نساؤنا هي او جابر او من وكلت بيتك هنا يا جابر حرقت خيارنا هي او جابر او تنس وبات اما زينب الكبرى عليها السلام فخرجت باكية إلى قبر الحسين حتى إذا وصلت إلى القبر الشريف
بنفسها على القبر وهي تنادي وحسينا ومظلوما وشهيدا يا ابن فاطمة الزهراء يا ابن علي المرتضى ولهفتا لبنات الطهر حين رنت إلى مصارع قتلاهن والحفري فتلك تدعو حسينا وهي لاطمة على الخدود ودمع العين كالمطر وتلك تصرخ وأبتا وجدا وتلك تصرخ ماذا تقول وأيتما في الصغر سيدي أبا عبد الله يا حبيب قلبي نحن جالسين هنا في هذا المكان لكن قلوبنا في كربلاء مع زوارك السائرين إليك وصلت أربعينك والله يا مظلوم وأنا ابن الزيارة هالسنة محروم والله محروم أنا الحبك سيدي يا حسين أنا الحبك جرى مجرى الدم بي تدرب حال قلبي بالأربعينية قلبي هناك سيدي عند ضريحك الطاهر في حسر أبقار سرايا من أشاهد سيدي مشية المشاية باعوا الدنيا وللموت شرايا والله شاهدهم وصيح والدمع مسجوب عايش النار بس قلبي ما هو وياك وين قلبك قلبي بكربلاء يا سيدي ومولاي انا مشتاق ليها مشتاق ليها اتعنم الشاي اواسي بالمشي زينب زينب ام كلثوم هنيئا هنيئا للي يزور ويتعفر على عتابه ويطلع للحرم ماشي ويستأذن على بابه ويقول له يا ابو السجاد يا ابو السجاد جيناك طلابه اطلبوا حوائجكم يا ربي يا ربي متى ترجعنا ونزور الشهيد حسين لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وسيعلم الذين ظلموا آل محمد أي منقلب ينقلبون والعاقبة للمتقين اللهم إنا نسألك وندعوك ونتوسل إليك بأحب الخلق إليك محمد وعلي وفاطمة والحسن والحسين إلهي بحق الأئمة المعصومين من ذرية الحسين بسيدتنا ومولاتنا عقيلة بني هاشم زينب الكبرى فرج عنا يا الله 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 عجل لوليك المهدي الفرج والعافية والنصر اجعلنا من خير أنصاره وأعوانه والمدافعين عنه والمستشهدين بين يديه اللهم أرنا الطلعة البهية والغرة الرشيدة واكحل نواظرنا بنظرة منا إليه اللهم عجل فرجا وسهل مخرجا وأوسع منهجا واسلك بنا محجة اللهم من كان في مجلسنا هذا صاحب حاجة أصحاب الحوائج إخواني الحاضرين أخواتي الحاضرات اللهم اقضي حوائجنا يسر أمورنا فرج همومنا وغمومنا اجمع شمل أحبتنا وأهلنا رد مسافرينا ولا سيما زوار قبر أبي عبد الله الحسين شافي مرضانا ارحم أمواتنا ولا سيما الحاجة كوثر شمس إلى أرواح جميع موتى المؤمنين والمؤمنات نهدي للجميع ثواب سورة المباركة الفاتحة تسبقها بأعلى أعلى أصواتكم صلوات